good, T minus.
Niggas even count me out. I'm counting my bullets, I'm loading my clips, I'm writing down names, I'm making a list, I'm checking it twice and I'm getting them hit. The real ones been dying, the fake ones is lit. The game is off balance, I'm back on my the Bentley is dirty.
Yo, what's going on, everyone? Here to talk to you guys today about my 2003 CR250. I did a little bit of work over it, onto it, I guess, over the winter. And I'm just going to kind of like run through some parts and give you guys like an overall build, as well as I did some parts last winter, and so I'm gonna kind of throw those in there as well, because obviously I'm not just gonna like replace my rotors that only have a season on them. So anyway, so the total build that I did this year costed $1,600. So that includes the graphic kit, the plastic kit, graphics kit, new tires, I had to do a bearing in the front wheel, a bling kit, a Tusca bling kit from Rocky Mountain ATV, FMF fatty pipe, FMF shorty, I can't even read my own handwriting, it's terrible, so, a clutch inner hub, that thing was like pretty dang worn out, you can't see it, but I have a hole shot device on there, sprockets, chain, new breeds, have the V, I think it's like a V2, it's like the three pedal, it's an older one, it's a carbon fiber reed block. Anyway, it's just cheaper, it's like $55 to, you know, what's up, talking about my bike, dog.
Okay,
I'll have to edit it out, dude. Now I gotta edit, man, I'm lazy. All right, so anyway, it's just cheaper for to replace the reeds themselves, the pedals themselves, it's $55. Where a whole, I think they're on V3 now. V-Force reeds is like $150, so it's just cheaper for me just to keep buying the older pedals. So anyway, that's what I keep doing. I'm thinking about going OEM as well, but I don't know. They might last a little longer than those carbon fiber ones, but that's alright. I got cheap radiators, like eBay radiators and hoses. My other brother got those couple years ago on his YZ450F, and they seem to be like okay for $100 radiators with hoses. He didn't have like any like overheating issues. I just changed my 1.8 bar cap that I bought from Rocky Mountain like 2 years ago. I just brought that over because I think it only came with like a 1.1 or something like that. So anyway, swap it over. Haven't had any issues. If I tip over and break, I'm really not gonna cry for over $100 radiators. I think OEM was like $300 or something. So anyway, and that didn't include the hoses. I got, DeVol radiator guards. You guys might be able to see them. I think they're aluminum. They bend pretty easily, but I got those instead of like the white plastic. Kind of looks nice. Then I just added like $50 for miscellaneous. So anyway, that was kind of like the list that I did. I kind of just quickly ran through it, but I can link everything down in the description. But yeah, there's like $1,600. And obviously the bike looks pretty good. I stripped it down to the frame this year, cleaned it up. I didn't pressure wash it when it was a frame or nothing. Like, it's a dirt bike, it's gonna get dirty. It's cool to see like fully freshed out, like rebuild guys, I guess, but I don't know, I don't have enough time for that. And it's like I said, it's just a dirt bike, so it's gonna get dirty anyway. But yeah, and then last year I got new rotors. Those are probably like $80. What else did I do? I got those Mika metal handlebars last year, last summer, like July. I crashed and bent my old ones, my older Mika metal bars. So those were maybe $80. It's the 7/8 bar MC bend. It's a sweet, like flat, short bend. It works really well on these older Hondas. I like that. I also did the spring as well. It's just a stock spring. Instead of being yellow, I just had it stripped and powder coated. That was like $55, but yeah, and then like a block, like a chain guide block, I think it's TM, that was like $80 last summer. But anyway, altogether that was pretty cheap, and you can actually like rebuild these bikes fairly cheap. You don't have to go out and spend. I think Dirt Bike Channel Kyle on his channel, I think they said they're up to like $7,000 or like $8,000, excluding labor, which is sweet, because his is just, he's just doing it like, he just uses his bike for trails, obviously. He just has such a different application than I have. I ride, like, strictly track, and if I, like, I hardly ride trails, so. This track, or obviously this is a bike, a motocross bike, and I'm taking on a motocross track, so I don't need to do, like, flywheel or revalve my suspension. Like, the suspension's actually set up pretty well for my weight at, like, 150, 155 pounds, depending on, like, how, where I'm at in the summer. It's fun. So, anyway, it is possible to, like, redo these bikes for, like, the average person. And honestly, like, I've taken this thing trail riding in the hills. I just need to gear it down a little bit, and it's fine. So you can just get, like, I'm running stock gearing 1348, which I like for this bike, but you could go, like, 1350, 1351 or something, which is awesome for climbing. You can lug it a little bit more. You feel like you don't have to, like, use the clutch as much, but anyway. So I just know that he was getting some flack for that. Like, people were like, oh, there's no way you don't need to spend $7,000 on to get, like, an 03 CR250 to, you know, to be, like, a pretty pretty good, like, daily driver. You can run it around. So so $1,500 or $1,600, she's good to go. I didn't do the top end this year. Last year I did a Vertex top end. I actually blew it up. I didn't seize it as bad as he did his, but I blew it up. I was running her a little lean last November. I still had my summer jetting. She was running crisp, but anyway, I blew her up. But I did had to do the cylinder, had to redo the cylinder, replate the cylinder, and then I think a Vertex piston kit's like $165, like, with the whole gasket kit, as well as, like, the Vertex piston and knuckle and all that, little retainer clips and everything for the piston. So anyway, these things are super cheap to rebuild, and I think I have about, like, 40 hours on it from last summer. I didn't get to ride as much. I was taking, like, a summer class and working a lot, but so anyway, yeah, $1,600, you can actually get yourself, like, you can get a pretty nice bike for $1,600. Buy a used bike. You learn a lot. I've learned so much in the last 2 years with owning this thing. If I would have went out and, like, bought a brand new KTM, there's no way I would have never been comfortable pulling a motor or none of that stuff. Until I, like, trial and error on an old bike, it's, like, the best way to do it. So, anyway, it's pretty fun. So, yeah. Anyway, yeah, that's my 2003 CR250 restyled kit with a Polysport kit and 2018 factory HRC graphics and some updated parts and bits here and there. So, thanks, guys. Have a good day.